Hello friends, in this video tutorial, we will learn how to make an advanced PHP Ajax date range filter application by using date range picker plugin with DataTable and Chart.js library. In previous tutorial, we have already learned how to integrate Chart.js library into jQuery DataTable plugin and make dynamic bar chart by using DataTable data with server-side processing of data using PHP with Ajax. And now in this part, we will integrate date range picker plugin into this DataTable and Chart.js application and make advanced date range filter application. So when we have filter data using PHP with Ajax, then at that time, DataTable and Chart.js library data must be changed in real time. In this tutorial, first we will create one text box for date range picker plugin. After this, we will write jQuery code for initialize date range picker plugin. Next, we will integrate date range picker plugin with jQuery data table library. After this, we will write PHP script for date range filter. And lastly, we will check advanced date range filter using date range picker output in the browser. And one more thing, we have put source code download link under this video description, so check it. Now let's start discussing this topic. So first, we have to open index.php file. And here, we can see that we have already included date range picker library file at the header of this file. Now first we have to move to HTML code part. And here, we have to create one text box for pop-up date range picker plugin. So for create text box, here we have to write input type is equal to text, and after this, we have to write id attribute is equal to date range text box, and class is equal to form control. Now we want to make read-only text box, so for this, here we have to write read-only attribute. So here our text box is ready. Now we have moved to write jQuery code for initialize date range picker plugin. So here in jQuery code part, we have to write $ with text box it date range text box. And then after, we have to write date range picker. So this method will initialize date range picker plugin. Under this method, we can write different option of this method. So here, first we have to write ranges option, and under this option, we can define different date ranges. Now under this option, we have to get today date range, so here we have to write today. And for get today date range, here we have to write array, so in array first index, we want to define start date. So for get today date, as start date, here we have to write moment function, and in second index, we have to define end date, which is also a today date, so for this also, we have to write moment function. So this code will make today date range. Next we want to make yesterday date range. So for this, here we have to write yesterday with double dot array and in array first index, we have to define start date, which is yesterday date, so for this, here we have to write moment function dot subtract method with two argument. In first argument, we have to write 1. And in second argument, we have to write days, so this method will minus 1 day from today date and return yesterday date. Now in end date option also, we have to get yesterday date also. So for this, here we have to write moment function dot subtract method with two argument like 1 and days, so it will return yesterday date. So in this option it will display yesterday date in start date and in end date. Now in third option, we want to display last 7 day date range. So for this, here we have to write last 7 days and array start date. Now we want to display 7 days before date. So for this, here we have to write moment function dot subtract method with two argument. In first argument, we have to write 6, and in second argument, we have to write days, so it will minus 6 days from today date. So for this, here we have to write moment function, which will return today date. Now here in browser, first we have to refresh web page, and after refresh of the web page, here we can see that one read only text box has been appear above the chart, and under that, it has displayed today date. Now we have to click on the text box, and after click on the text box, here we can see that Date range picker has been pop up on the web page with option like today date, yesterday date, and last 7 days filter. Date range picker has been pop up on the web page with option like today date, yesterday date, and last 7 days filter. Now we have to click on the yesterday filter, so after click on the yesterday filter. Here in the text box, we can see that yesterday date has been displayed under the text box. Now we have go to index.php file, and here, we want to add last 30 days filter. So here, we have to write last 30 days text box, in start date option, we want to display date before 29 days. So for this, here we have to write moment function dot subtract method with 2 argument. And in first argument, we have to write 29 days, and in second argument, we have to write days. So it will minus 29 days from the today days. Now in second option, we want to display today date. So for this, here we have to write moment function, which will return today date. So here, last 30 day date range is set. Now here, we have to refresh web page, and after refresh of web page, here we have to click on the text box. So here, date range picker has been pop up on the web page, and here we can see that last 30 days, date range has been added. Now we have to click on the last 30 day range, so it has display, date before 29 days, in start date. And it has display today date, in the end date. Now we want to add, this month date range, so for this. We have go to index.php file, and here we have to write this month text box, and in start date. We want to display current month first date, so for this, here we have to write moment function. Dot start of function, with month as argument, so it will return current month first date, and same way in the end date option. We want to display end date of the current month, so for this, here we have to write moment function. Dot end of method, and under this, we have to write month, so it will return current month end date. Now here, we have to refresh web page, and after refresh of web page, here we have to click on the text box. So here, we can see that date range picker has been pop up on the web page, and here we can see that this month option has been added, and now we have to click on the this month option. So after click on the option, here we can see that current month, start date, and end date has been displayed in the text box. Now in this date range, we want to end last month date range. So for this, we have go to index.php file, and here we have to write last month option, and in the start date option, we want to display last month first date. So for this, here we have to write moment function dot subtract method with 2 argument. In the first argument, we have to write 1, and in the second argument, we have to write month, so it will minus 1 month. From the current month, after this, we want to get that month first date, so here, we have to write start of function with month as argument, so it will return last month first date. And in the end date option, we want to display last month last date, so here, we have to write moment function dot subtract method with 2 argument, and in the first argument, we have to write 1. And in second argument, we have to write month, so it will return last month. Now forget last month last date. Here we have to write end of method, and under this, we have to write month, so it will return last month last date. Now here we have to refresh web page, and after refresh of web page, here we have to click on the text box. So here we can see that date range picker has been pop up on the web page, and here we can see that last month date range has been added. Now we have to click on the last month date range, so after click on the last month date range. Here in text box, we can see that last month first date and last date has been displayed in the text box. Suppose we want to filter date between custom date range, so by click on this custom date option. We can filter data with custom date range filter also. Now here date must be changed when we have to click on the any date range. So for this, we have go to index.php file, and here we have to write format option. By using this option, we can see the date format, so here we have to define date format. After this, we have to write callback function with start and end argument. So this function will be called on every date range filter, and it will receive start date and end date as argument. So this function will be called on every date range filter, and it will receive start date and end date as argument. But before reload data table data, first we want to destroy data table. So for this, here we have to write dollar with table id order table with date table method dot destroy method. So this code will destroy date table instance. Now for reload data table data, here we have to call page data function. So this function will reload data table data. But now we want to page data with date range filter. So for this, we have to write date range filter under this function. So here we have to write start date and end date argument. Now we want to pass this variable value with Ajax request. So in data option, we have to write start date and end date variable. So with Ajax request, this variable value will be sent. Now here also, we have to pass this date start and end date variable. So for passed start date, here we have to write start.format function with date format. And same way for pass end date, here we have to write end.format function with date format. So this way, date range picker start date and end date data has been passed under this page data function. So here our jQuery code is ready for initialize date range picker plugin. And pass start date and end date range value with the data table Ajax request. Now we have go to action.php file. And here, we have already write PHP script for fetch data from order table. Now we need to add PHP script for fetch filter data according to particular date range. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write is set function, and under this function, we have to write $post start date variable and $post end date variable. So this condition will check if this both variable value is set, then it will execute if block of code. After this, here in condition, we have to write and operator with $post start date variable value is not equal to blank. So this condition will check if this variable has some value, and after this, we have again write and operator. And write $post end date variable value is not equal to blank, so here this complete if condition will check. If both variable value is set, and both variable has some value, if this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. And under this block, we have to write $search query variable, and here we have to append query like order date table column value must be greater than or equal to the value of $post start date variable value. And order date table column value must be less than or equal to the value of $post end date variable value and. So here, we have to append date range filter query under this $search query variable, search query. So other code, we have already write, so we do not need to write any code, so here our PHP code is ready. For date range filter MySQL table data, using PHP script with Ajax, so we have to save this code and check output in the browser. Friends, here we have to refresh web page, and after refresh of web page, here we can see that in date range filter date box, we can see that today start and end date, and in the jQuery data table, we can see current month order data has been loaded in jQuery data table with server side processing of data. And in bar chart also, last order data also, this is because in bar chart, it has display jQuery data table data in the bar chart. Now we have to click on the text box, then date range picker has been pop up on the web page. And from that, we have to select yesterday option. So after selecting yesterday option, here we can see that only one data has been displayed in jQuery data table. Now again, we have to click on the text box. And again date range picker has been pop on the web page, and now we have to select last 7 day option. So after selecting last 7-day option, here we can see that last 7-day data has been displayed in the data table. And from data table data, here we can see that bar chart has been generated. Now we want to get this month all data. So we have again to click on the text box, and from this date range filter option, we have to select this month. So after selecting this month option, here we can see that this month order data has been displayed in the jQuery data table, and from that data table data, here we can see that bar chart also created for this current month order data. Now we want to get last 2 month data, so here we have to click on the text box, and date range picker has been pop on the web page. We cannot see filter last 2 month date, but here we can see custom filter option, so we have select custom filter option. So here, we can see that 2 calendar has been appear for select start date and end date. So here, we have to select start date, and after this, we have to select end date, and after this, we have to click on apply button. So after click on the apply button, here we can see that last 2 month order data has been loaded in the jQuery data table and in the chart also. We can see last 2 month data has been displayed, so this way, we can integrate date range picker plugin into this jQuery data table and chart.js application using Ajax with PHP and MySQL database. And make advanced date range filter application. So in this part, we have learned how to use date range picker with PHP application and how to integrate with data table and chart.js library. So if you have any query or input regarding this tutorial, so you can comment your query into comment box. We will review your comment and solve your query.